Hello guys, welcome again to this next lesson of this tutorial set. In this tutorial we are going to talk about a unique feature in Blender that is called the 3D cursor. Well, 3D cursor is this small circle that you see in the center of the 3D world. It looks like a sniper scope target, okay, and it can be used in a lot of things, but mainly the 3D cursor defines the location where newly objects that you will create are going to appear, okay? There are four ways to change it. The first one is to using mouse. You can press shift and right click of the mouse in any part of the 3D world, and as you can see we are changing its location. If we click on the object, 3D cursor will snap, will be snapped to the face of that object. Another method is to use the 3D cursor tool mode, that is this button over here on the menu, and you can change it by simply click with the left click on each part of the screen. Another way to change it is using the 3D cursor tool mode. You can go here to object, for example, snap, and you have a lot of options. Cursor to selected, to world origin, to grid, and to active. For example, let's select an object. First, let me select the select box so that I can select an object. Okay, and then object, snap, cursor to active. This means that it will move the cursor to the object that is selected. Okay, as you can see, now we have our cursor on the selected object. Another way that you can do this is by press, for example, shift S, okay, and you can select cursor to active, and it will move the cursor again to the active object, but in this case you just need to press shift and S. Another way that you can do it is by using the toolbar. You can press N to show the toolbar. We have seen this on the first tutorial, or you can just simply drag and drop this little arrow over there. I will do it again. Okay, I think it's easier with the N key. Okay, and you have three coordinates, X, Y, and Z. Okay, and you can move the cursor by changing those parameters. You can write those parameters, or you can simply click and move your mouse to the left or to the right to increase or to decrease the value. Blender will work with this method in a lot of things, this is something that you will gonna use a lot, because you can change the values by simply click and move your mouse. To reset the location, you have another ways also. The first one is shift and C. Okay, shift C will move your 3D cursor to the center of the world, but also if you are looking at another part of the scene and you press shift and C, you will see, and your view will be changed to the center of the world also. You can use the menu again, snap cursor to world origin. Okay, imagine that we have changed it and you want to reset this position. You can use the object menu, snap, and cursor to world origin. And another way is again on the 3D cursor, on the toolbar. Okay, let me just change it here. Over here you can click with the right click of the mouse and reset all to default values. And it is going, it have gone to the world origin. That's it. We will use this in the future, but for now that's important that you know how it works, and you can practice, try to do this that I have done during this tutorial, so that you can know how it works, because we are going to use it in the next tutorial when I will show you how you can create objects. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope to see you soon.